know, Zao. I know. This is the true work of a shaman.
Yes. I hope we can find his son. I pray he is alive and well.
I think this is Bomani's son's mask.
It would seem so. Cracked and damaged.
reflecting. Maybe it could help. Talking. Or sometimes, maybe not. I'm so used to just doing. All the time, doing.
It is not as if you are doing nothing now, Zhao.
No. You are right. I am healing. I guess.
Aditya Shukudu, Zhao, you now possess within you Shukudu's might. And what a mighty predecessor he was. Long ago, a great evil amassed in the harsh dunes. It was a creature of unspeakable wickedness and insidious intent. It sought to drain the spirit of the earth, protecting itself in a dome of shimmering blackened stone. The great Shukudu refused to allow this horror to pass. He charged with all his might the fury of the gods within him as he broke through the impenetrable dome. He took a mighty step forward, and that made all the difference.
A might that helped save this world. I hope I can live up to his valiance. I will wield this in his honor.
This spear is near identical to Bomani's.
I do not doubt this is a clue to his son's location. We draw close to our answer. Why would the son abandon his mask and spear?
Let us keep looking.
The act of parent to child is an understanding that transcends mortality, that surpasses even the strength of gods.
Choka, the great bastion of the north. Where Ikakaramba found power in innovation, where Kivuli in adaptation, Ichoka found it in endurance. sealed gate to the mountain summit. We must open the gate if we are to find the Great Spirit. I believe this is the Enduring Rite, a test of the soul's worthiness. It demands a bout, but not just with brawn. And it calls upon the mind, but not just with strategy. And we, Zhao, must find the two great keys to venture forth.
Then let us find them.
Legendary fighting pits, where the sons and daughters of Itshoka would prove their mettle. The power of the fighting spirit is integral to the aspirant.
see that? It must be the first key for the gate.
Our first key attained. Now one remains.
It took me a long time to let go of my mother. Pain, then anger. But I realized there's no point holding on to the past like that. She yearned for something else. I guess that temptation took over. Baba and I once talked of where she could be. He knew she did not return to Echoka. He came here often enough. No. He thought maybe she had gone beyond Kenzera.
To see the world?
To be free to follow her path. A path without Baba and I. I do not think Baba ever got over it. I think he loved her more than anything.
I doubt more than he loved you. Let us go. There is much more to cross. The great shrine to the desert gods. The two pillars of Echoka, devotion and determination, shine bright. To fight without thought is foolish. A bird in the sky is beholden to the wind under its wing. here lies our second key. We are getting even closer to our goal. It's done. That is both keys now in our possession. Now we must return to the gate. It is time to brave the power of the mountain.
In our age, three spirits do reside. One of sky, one of earth, one of mankind.
We go now to the mountain summit. Find the Great Spirit. Find Bomani's son. Put everything to rest.
Bomani's necklace.
Bringing peace to Bomani is a good cause. The sun must have buried him, but there is no one here. So where is the sun?
Therein lies the mystery, one we must resolve in line with our goal. The summit awaits.